Believe me, it will do that.
There you go.
Hi, Altrincham. How are you doing?
Hi.
Welcome along to, not a Wednesday, but a Tuesday evening.
Apologies about that. I can't do Wednesday. You can't do Wednesday either, so we've decided to just do a Tuesday and give you a quick update on what's happening around the Altrincham area. So hope you're all well. If you want to comment on the show, as we're doing it, please do. We do like hearing from you. So how are you?
I'm good. I've had a very long day. Mm. Interesting, productive.
Well, yeah.
Something to work on, yeah.
Oh, cool.
I'm quite pleased with myself. Yeah.
I've got to say, I think I'm getting ill.
Oh, dear.
Yeah. You know the leggy that's going around at the moment? I just feel so under the weather. No. Oh yeah, man flu, I forgot. Man flu's much worse than any other flu that a woman could get, or childbirth, or anything. But apparently so. So yeah, and today we're joined by Chris as well.
Hi.
So yeah, let's start.
Chris behind the camera there doing Joe's job. Hi Joe.
Yeah, hi Joe. So I want to kick off actually today. I want to go back to Remembrance Day, which was on Sunday. Just a few things I want to say about that. I just want to kind of just say it was absolutely lovely, all the services that were around the Altrincham, Hale and Bowden and Hale Barnes area. And there was a parade actually in Hale that was outside Lee Road. It was by Hale Library as well, that started at 2:55. That was to honour all of those who had fallen in the World Wars and all the other wars that had occurred up to present day, to be honest. There were many tributes and poppy wreaths as well placed around memorial areas, and especially on Chapel Street. And I'm actually responding now to a viewer who commented on Sunday, Gavin Critchley.
Gavin Critchley.
Yeah.
Hi Gavin.
Hi. You mentioned the Fallen 50. So I'm just going to give a bit of information about those people. I've got my notes here, as usual. Chapel Street in Altrincham, it had 161 residents from Altrincham sign up to serve the country in First World War. And unfortunately, 29 were killed in action. And 20 of those men were actually succumbed to the war wounds. So it was 49 of these that died. I know it's Fallen 50, I couldn't quite find out where the 50th was. If anyone knows that, please let me know, I'd be really interested. George V, who was king at the time, he actually described Chapel Street as the bravest street in England, and many of these men were Irish immigrants who were working as labourers, and they couldn't find work, so they signed up to serve the country, and the youngest was 16. Just think about your children at the moment signing up. 16, the oldest 44, so they both lied about their age to do this, to serve the country. And I've got to say, it really does touch me, these Remembrance Day services, just watching what happens, because it's just, you know, they gave their lives so we could live ours in peace. Well, as peaceful as we can
at the moment.
Peaceful as
we can, just exactly the same.
You know, my granddad served in the war. He was actually in the Navy, and he saved his ship. I'm very, very proud of that fact.
My granddad was in the Navy.
How was he?
Yeah.
Oh.
All I can remember, to be honest.
I've got some beautiful photos of him in the sailor suit that he used to send to my nana. And, I cherish those. I've still got his war medals. But, I think Remembrance Day is something that definitely needs to be remembered. So that's a bit of a summer start. But a bit of information for you as well. So, moving on to the Altrincham markets. Someone asked, what are we doing for these Altrincham markets? So, I've got some info here. The organisers are going to have twilight markets, and there's going to be two of them. First one, Friday the 9th of December, they're going to feature, it's a festive food, mulled wine, carol singers, live music, late night shopping, so it'll be lovely just to get in the Christmas spirit. There's also another one going to be the 16th of December, so this is, if you don't know where the market is by the way, it's on Greenwood Street in Altrincham. So they're hosting these two late night events that will be the same. They haven't actually said who exactly is going to be singing, but it's going to be carol singers from around the area. I will try and find out for you. Entry is free, so that's a bonus. Take the family. They're going to be selling handmade gifts, goodies, kitchen items, you know, nice little things that can be Christmas gifts. Inside the food hall, they're going to be offering a special menu as well. It would be nice actually to go down and sample them.
I think we should, given that we had those cakes the other week, then I think we should go and eat some more.
Yeah, I think, Chris, sample, are you up for doing a walk around the Ultramarine Market when these are on?
Yeah.
On the Friday, I think that would be lovely if we go and sample them.
Yeah.
Yeah, it'd be nice. Watch this space for that, guys. The menus are going to be designed exclusively just for the opening with Christmas in mind, so it's not going to be a set menu constantly. Just for Christmas, but bear this in mind, and go down. There's going to be a turkey sandwich with apple chestnut stuffing, and a triple B, big, I can't say this word properly, Bratwurst, am I saying it right? If anyone knows how to say that.
Say that again, but quickly.
Bratwurst, I don't know how to say it. Basically, it's a big German sausage, baguette from National 7. So, yeah, I don't know if I'll be sampling that one, but if the boys want to, that's fine. I might have a turkey sandwich. There is an American indie band called Blind Pilots who will perform inside the venue's food hall. I'm sure that's going to be amazing. The market bosses promise there'll be more live music in the spaces of the coming weeks. Just so you know the times of it as well, many of you don't know the times of the Ultramarine Market, I've heard. They're open Tuesdays, Thursdays, Fridays, Saturdays and Sundays, so Monday and Wednesday is the close, that's their days off. They're going to be open on Christmas Eve until 6 p.m, so anyone looking for a present, it says here, and food for the big day, go down there, have a look. I'm sure it's going to be really nice and artisan. You can get your presents there, you can go and have a look, go around and look at things and go, oh, I want that.
Incidentally, are we going to have a Secret Santa going on here?
Yeah. What do you think, Chris? Should we have a Secret Santa?
Depends.
We can do a Poundland Secret Santa.
Poundland.
A Poundland Secret Santa. So we have to buy the most outrageous gift for each other, but for £1 from Poundland.
Well, yeah.
I think that'd be quite good.
You heard it here. It's on.
And we will open them on the show together as a family.
I'm looking forward to that.
I think that'd be quite good. Maybe £3 limit if you've got it. They're also going to have a quirky New Year's Eve party. If you're stuck, I know we're mentioning the C word now, but it's coming, and it's coming quickly, so we're going to have to tackle it. New Year's Eve party, that's going to be starting as well. Closing hours for trade are going to be 7:30 p.m, and then reopening at 8:30 p.m, so this is around and in the Christmas market. And it's going to see in the new year, so it's going to be open until 2 p.m. That's going to be amazing, but wrap up warm. I'm sure it's going to be quite cold, but it's going to be amazing for people to go down. I'm sure there's going to be lots of fun, lots of bands. So that's what's going on in the Christmas market. It is closed December the 24th, 25th, 20th. Oh no, sorry, I'm sorry. It's open the 24th, 9 till 6 p.m. It's closed the 25th, 26th, give them a couple of days off. It's back open then, the normal hours, and then it's Saturday the 31st of January, 9 till 7:30 p.m, and then 8:30 p.m. till 2 p.m, so that is New Year's Eve. It is then closed Saturday the 1st and Monday the 2nd, sorry, Sunday the 1st and Monday the 2nd. So that's 2018. That's scary.
Really?
2018, that's absolutely terrifying.
So, in the future?
Yeah.
That's my flying car.
Have you noticed that everything's just, all the year is going so fast?
That's because you're getting old, my dear.
I'm not getting old. I put the Santa Christmas decorations up a week ago and I've only just taken them down. Now it's time to put them up again soon. I don't know what's happening. I was talking to Mr. B about this the other day as well. Time is flying so quickly. It's like, where's it going? And I'm putting it down to time flies when you're having fun. But I don't know what to do. I want it to slow down.
It's either that or you've got a time machine. Funnily enough, I could make use of one of those right now.
Yeah, I could. I'd go back and I'd get the lotto ticket. Yes. I think many people would as well, but perhaps not myself. Right, okay, so just coming up to more about this Christmas season. I've actually had a lot of people... Because I run the community centre in Bowdoin, I've had a lot of people ask me are you collecting donations for homeless people? Because we did this one year, and we had so many items brought in. We had bottles of water and duvets and even tents and everything, because, you know, I mean, they need help all year round, not just at Christmas, but people tend to give more at Christmas, especially when it's colder. So the outpouring of generosity was staggering, I have to say. But I've been actually looking around now, where do people want to donate unwanted items, or want to, you know, just give bottles of water to people, or anything that they can. So I did get advice actually today from someone. I think she did do work at one point. I'm not going to mention who it was because I haven't asked her, but it was Altrincham Homeless Action Group, and she did mention churches will take in donations and items. And I'm going to bring you up to date if you're interested at drop-off points. The closest that I've found at the moment is I've got Skullfades. I hope I'm saying that right. Skullfades Foundation Barbershop, which is next to M&S in Sale. So they actually collect items and distribute them as well. So anything you don't want, jumpers, socks, they need underwear, they need all sorts. I remember people were giving soap, they were giving deodorant, anything, just things to make people feel human again. I think it's quite important. I know people do a lot for the homeless at Christmas, but
yeah,
there's always people that
like
will miss out.
It's an all year round problem.
Yeah.
It always has been.
Yeah.
It's time to change it.
Yeah,
it
is. It's quite sad that we still have homeless people on the street. My personal baby, Animal Charities, they need help at this time. They need blankets, old blankets you don't want, even old sweaters, food. If you feel like making a donation, go down to your local animal shelter. These animals are starving. Sometimes they don't even have heat. So anything that you can do to make their little lives feel better, even a toy, that would be fantastic. So I will get down helping them. My furry little friends.
Are you a cat or a dog person?
I'm both. I actually don't have a preference. I just love them both. Because we've got two donkeys at my house as well, two rescue donkeys. And they're not little donkeys, they're big donkeys. And someone actually wanted to borrow the donkey for the, it was the, you know, the Midnight Mass. So we actually did lend one of the donkeys out, and unfortunately, the donkey did a great big steaming pile of crap in the actual aisle. So it was like everyone was just completely ignoring the fact that this donkey had just basically pooed in the middle of the aisle. It really smelled as well. So the church was warm and had this kind of this odour about it. So we're there trying to clean it
up. Church.
Yeah. Just carry on like it's not happened. Yeah, they didn't use the donkey again, which, why didn't you? It's behave now. It's quite funny. So, yeah, that's my information that I've got today.
Okay, cool. You're being quite professional, aren't you?
I like my notes.
You do?
I do like my notes. I changed my iPad, actually. I've got a new iPad. I got some money off. I changed my old iPad and got this one. So I've got a lot of space on it, so I've got a lot of games on it.
Oh, gamer. You're not a Candy Crush person, are you?
I certainly am not. I am a Goat Simulator person. If anyone's ever played Goat Simulator, best thing I've ever seen in my life. It's hilarious. Hours of fun.
Is that not a little close to a Farmville?
No, it's not. You're basically a goat that goes around terrorising people, and you can headbutt them, but you have missions to do and trophies to get. It's about £5 from the internet, but it really is worth it. It's hilarious. Apart from, well, I'm there laughing, so I think it's quite funny, so.
That sounds very therapeutic.
It's brilliant. I love it.
Hi, by the way, to Chris Aki Atkinson.
Hi, Chris.
Always a regular. Thanks for tuning in, Chris, and watching. Just keep watching, mate. We're getting better at this, aren't we? Eh?
Yeah, and if anyone has any comments or anything, or wants to ask us anything, that is absolutely fine. I was thinking about an Agony Aunt and Uncle thing.
Oh, yes, well, you know.
I was thinking that someone did suggest something to me that we respond to people's issues. So there's a lot of people that have got issues on things at the moment, like, let's see.
Oh.
Surviving Christmas. People want to know about surviving Christmas, even how to cook a turkey. Now put it in the oven, don't get food poisoning. What to buy people for Christmas. I have a big issue, actually, about what to buy and to be for Christmas. It is our first Christmas together, and I don't know what to buy him. And you know that first Christmas thing when you're like, how much are you going to spend on each other?
Yeah.
Oh my God, am I going to spend like loads on him? He's going to spend nothing on me, or vice versa. Or if you just buy the wrong gift and they absolutely hate it and have got to act like they like it. This is my biggest fear at the moment. I swear to God, it's stressing me out. I don't know what to get him. If anyone has ideas, I'm not going to subscribe him actually, but I don't know what to buy him. But I'm very good at telling people what to buy other people. I'm really good about that.
Oh, maybe you can do my Christmas shopping for me. I'm helping you. I'm useless. Absolutely useless.
Well, do you know, a woman, you've got to think about this for a woman. I know someone who got bought a Hoover one Christmas from a boyfriend. And I said, what did you get? They went a Hoover. A year after, they got a slow cooker. And I was like, has he not got you anything? Like, just lovely and thoughtful about yourself. And it was like, I said, why don't you buy something like a nice purse, like just something that can last her, or, you know, just spend a bit of money on it. Something girly, perfume, or just even like an experience or something that she'd really like, a spa pampering night, or, you know, depending on what money you have. Not everyone can afford to like spend a lot, not everyone wants to spend a lot, but, you know, I don't think Christmas is just for kids. I think it's for absolutely everyone to enjoy. It's mainly about being with people you love, I think.
Being a bloke, of course, I have the benefit of being a child at heart.
Yes.
So
you'd be fine with what? What would be your perfect Christmas gift?
Oh, dearie me. Now, people ask me this on birthdays. Mm. What do you want for your birthday? It's not your birthday. What do you want? What do you want? Gets closer and closer, and I'm just like,
mm-hmm. See, I've started to know what I like. I've actually started to look at things and go, I really want that. And people say, what do you want? And cheekily, I go, I want that. And I think, not in a million years they would buy me that. Like a really nice handbag. And anyway, I've ended up with this handbag and I'm thinking, how much can I push this? It's like, can I get the matching purse? Or can I get this, that and the other? And I know, do you know what? I quite like spoiling my family at Christmas. And I quite like getting little gifts back because it's a little treat. It's magical, but it's lovely being with your family. And we're having Mr. B's parents over for Boxing Day.
Okay.
I know.
This won't be the first time you've met them.
No, I've met them.
Okay.
It might be.
It's not quite often happens.
Well, I'm going to my parents, so we're having. My mother actually met them the other day. She approved.
That
was alright. So
that helps.
It's all going well.
That
we're not going to murder each other at Christmas. That's the main thing. But yeah, if you have any issues that you want me and Andy to sort out, if you know the email address, or if you want to messenger us on Facebook, send us a little anonymous message, that's fine. Just put anonymous at the top if you don't want us to say your name. Because I know there is an online blogger who has actually done that when a man was going on about an impotency problem. And he put at the end, please don't say my name, and I accidentally said the name, and she just went, oh my God. It was possibly the funniest thing I've ever seen, but not funny for him. So if you have anything that you want us to sort out for you, Auntie and Uncle here can do this, especially over the coming Christmas period.
This ties in a little bit with the mask off things I was doing months ago about mental health.
All right.
Yeah, so it's something that interests me. I have a little experience of my own, as you know,
from the
past videos. It interests me, and I found that what I was doing, what I was saying, helped people.
Yeah.
So I understand a little bit. Yeah, let's talk about it.
I mean, we're not trained therapists, but
we've
got decent heads on our shoulders, and we can give some really good... It's taking it. It's really good. No, we can be nice. It depends on the tone of the email. But we will give some advice. We will be happily there for your needs and your advice pleasure. What can I say?
We're
not going down that road. We won't have that dancing in the corner or anything today. So, never mind. Right, shall we introduce Chris?
I think
Chris has got a few things you want to say.
We have a special guest.
We do.
Shall I hitch up a little bit here?
We don't usually get you in the week.
No, no, it's different, isn't it? This is strange.
Come hither. How's Chris today?
So, in case we have not met before, this is Chris. Say hi, Chris!
Are you taking the men?
Would I do that?
No, no, boys.
Well, hi everyone. I'm back again from this morning doing my like little walk around, which was out of the blue. I was just on my way to work and I thought, I know, I'll do it to Tuesday morning. Let's go and do a little walk around, guess where I am. But everyone got it right, so if you want to go and... Anyway, I'm here to talk about the old Shingham light turn on, which is this coming Saturday. Everything starts around 12-ish with Ultra Unlimited. It's going to be turned. Everything's going to be quite busy. I'm looking forward to it.
It certainly was last year.
Yeah, it starts at 4:30,
I think.
Is it?
Yeah, it starts around 1 to about 5.
I think maybe that's the main event. I seem to remember the last couple of years going in there in the mornings, late mornings, and there's something going on.
I think it's really exciting. Everyone's going on about the Christmas lights right now, so.
It's becoming well known, like Goose Green Festival.
Yeah.
Old Shingham's getting itself on the map.
It certainly is. Chris, what are you doing at this switch on?
I'm hosting.
That's going to be brilliant.
I'm hosting round town. I'm not sure what my job is yet. That's. I will tell everyone when I get the information through.
That'd be brilliant.
But there is quite a lot of stars coming on the stage with Key 103.
Mm-hmm.
Which I'm looking forward to seeing again, because the guys that played at the Hill Fest, was it the Market Festival at Hill Fest?
No, I missed that actually.
The what they call the Marketplace Choir, they're attending there, so if you were there at the festival, they're playing again on the stage. And also on the 2nd of December, they're doing an Old Shingham Lantern Parade, which is going to be quite a big thing.
Oh, that's amazing! That sounds really good. That's a Saturday, isn't it?
Yes.
What time's that?
All day.
Is that the one that starts in Goose Green?
It's starting. That, well, I can't say anything at the moment.
Oh, is it a secret? I thought it had all been announced. I'm sorry.
If it accidentally said anything, I
apologise. It probably just starts in the Stamford Quarter where they're going to watch and make the lanterns and then they'll just walk.
Yeah.
With everything else, but.
Oh, that's going to be brilliant. Oh,
hi, Joanne. Where have you been?
Yeah, Joanne, I'm doing your job for a change tonight. It's good, isn't it?
Good job.
It's very easy. I don't know. I was like, can't be bothered.
It's doing great.
But you know, it's like I try and do everything I can. As Wednesday evenings are Kate and Andy's show, and I thought Tuesday nights and my nights with what we do. But anyway, next Tuesday we'll be live with Mike Williams.
Oh, is he the Wishing Well?
Yeah, I always call him Old Shingham Radio Wishing Well. No, it's Radio Wishing Well at Trafford General.
Yeah.
As Mike calls it, Radio Woohoo.
Oh, that's quite cool.
Because he says, I say radio and I go woohoo round Sainsbury's where I work.
I believe he's itching to take me on again.
Yes, he is.
Oh, okay.
Take you
You're on, mate.
Yeah,
what happened?
These two fight all the time over music and being that because of like the same age and
yeah.
The fight.
No, excuse me. I think you'll find Mike is older.
Well, exactly.
Well, anyway, regardless of what age it is,
why do you
fight over music? Is it just different music tastes or?
No, we've got the same music tastes.
Yeah.
And,
yeah.
We just want to have a laugh with each other.
Yeah. Well, that's fine. Makes it
entertaining.
See, I've got quite an opinion on some music, to be honest.
Okay.
I do like the music, but then I do the music. I go to the Moss Trooper sometimes.
Oh, no.
And I do the pub quiz then. They've got the music round. Oh, it's so quick. I'm so
fast.
Oh,
you think? And what sort of music are you?
I'm quite diverse. I've got an eclectic music taste. So, from training in ballet and stuff, I know a lot of classical music to jazz to all sorts of pop, rock and stuff.
Oh,
but
wow.
I am quite diverse. I know what I like, I know what I don't like.
I think we've just got ourselves an Ultimate News pub quiz team together.
Oh, actually, no, I love it. I am so competitive. I am ridiculously competitive. If someone starts having a conversation while I'm doing a pub quiz, I'm like, shut it.
But they hear that. That
right, the Thursday one, the actual Thursday one at the Moss Trooper is, I've just said the day, it's Thursday at the Moss Trooper every night. It starts at 9 o'clock and it goes on until about 11, 11.30. It just depends on, you know, how many people are playing or the answers and stuff. It is hilarious. And the guy who hosts it, I can't remember his name, it's been ages since I've gone. He also makes cakes as well. And anyone who comes second, he brings little fairy cakes in for people. And I love them. And do you know what? I always want to come second so I can get these little fairy cakes. But you win £20 behind the counter to spend. You've got 1 week to spend it. So we just spend it on like drink or dessert or something.
Oh, when you say you always want to come second, are you implying you always come first?
We have come first a lot. Listen, my things were the music and the arts. I was really good at that. I'm slightly like that about science, but I'm okay. So, what's your subject? Sport for me. I'm just
football, fishing. What's all I'm about?
Oh no! Are you any good at sport?
No. I'm an 80s.
Well,
fan.
We're going to fail. That's basically
it. I love my 80s music, especially some of the recent remixes and dance versions.
Do you listen to, what is it? Is it Smooth 80s or something, or is it Magic 80s? Which radio station is it?
I don't really listen to the radio.
They've got an 80s
station. I've got a laptop full of stuff that appeals to me, and YouTube, all I need.
He keeps playing the same thing, like Belinda Carlisle, like constantly. But Mr. B likes to play Six Music, because it's an independent music station. It has no adverts. It's got the Freak Zone on it, and I think that's every Saturday night or something, and some of the rubbish on that, I'm sorry, it sounds like animals being tortured or just the same note being held, and they're like, yes, it's an amazing diverse piece of music, oh my god, I could listen to them, it's like, oh, shut up, it's like, really?
You sound like my mum and dad used to. That's not music.
Well, he took me to a gig. It was at the Manchester Academy, I think it was. And we went to this gig, and I'm not going to say who the woman was playing, because some of you might know her. She is from Liverpool. And I've got to say, I was quite drunk and taking the mickey, and after every single really odd song she was playing, I was like, bravo! That's amazing! Bravo! Like that, just really taking the mickey. And I just said, if you ever take me to anything like that again, we will never see each other. It's like, I'm not going to take you to that again. I thought it was rubbish. And you should have seen the warm-up act as well. It was someone playing two notes on an organ and just there like he was frozen in time. And that was it. Constantly playing two notes and then it changed to a different note. And then another note, but that was it. How was that? Not in my ears. So, yeah, I was not impressed.
We had a debate on music one night.
Oh,
we've both been music people.
Yeah, we should play Name That
we'll
Song.
Get Mike on here as well.
We should have a game of Name That Song with a little buzzer.
Yeah, why not? A little quiz show.
A little quiz show. If you've got any quiz questions that you want to ask us, do it. Don't get rude or anything. Just like keep them nice and normal.
That's okay.
Quiz question, yeah. Nice and normal. No, I can't deal with a bit of blue on this. Oh. But but yeah, I would challenge you in a music thing.
Okay.
And I would win.
Okay, so we've established the game of Santa and a music quiz tonight.
Yep.
We're making progress.
That would be quite good. When do we open our presents? When do we all get together to open the presents?
I would imagine it would be the last live, possibly, maybe Sunday?
Yeah, the last
Christmas.
The whole team.
Probably. What day is Christmas Day?
Sunday.
The 25th, like every other year.
Is it?
I think it's a Sunday.
No, but what? Not date,
no, it's
what day?
Is it Monday? Is that a Monday? But
it's a Saturday.
Was it?
So it's going to have to be on the 19th.
It'll be the 18th. We'll have to do it on that. Oh, hang on, I'm looking at the wrong date here.
And we can carry out this admin behind the scenes and post it on the page.
Well, I think we need to have a little bowl of people's names of our team written on here. Mike from Wishing Well, if you want to join in this. A £3 limit from Poundland.
£3? I go to World County, you won't know the difference.
So, yeah, you've £3 limits, and whatever you think will suit that person.
Oh,
or slightly outrageous.
Oh, and it's not even that.
Can you get a sex doll for £3?
I think these guys are
you serious?
Poundland.
Horrified.
Shall I write that down for you so you can remember?
No, please no. I'm horrified. Oh my God.
I've never seen it. Mind you, I've not been looking for them.
I was only joking, by the way.
Oh no. Make your own.
I guess that depends what you consider a sex doll, doesn't it?
Anyway, moving swiftly on. Right, have we got anything else, boys?
I think we're just about done.
Are we just about done for today?
Yeah,
great. We've covered a good half hour.
I think we have.
I wouldn't want to bore you any longer.
Oh, it's been good.
I know. Well, thank you. Thanks for coming down, Chris.
That's fine. I'm here.
Thanks so much for doing the lighting and everything.
That's fine.
Making sure it doesn't fall over.
Oh, it's just mad last one on Sunday.
Yeah. Right, time to say goodnight, Altrincham. And I will be joining you again on Wednesday. I think you're on Sunday.
Yeah, Sunday.
We're back on Sunday, yeah.
Sunday,
yeah.
And my live will be on Thursday evening at 7:30.
Excellent. Can I just take it the breakfast show is going to be live on Thursday? Say that again, I'm really tired. I'm
right, okay.
Right.
Thursday. Right, sorry guys, I'm just going to do my little... Thursday, I will be doing a walk around on Thursday evening about 7:30. And I'll be back on the sofa with Andy on Sunday at 8 o'clock.
So when's the next breakfast show?
A week on Thursday.
We'll do it in two weeks. Right, okay. Great, so hopefully you've got that. Sorry about that confusion. And we shall see you very soon, Altrincham.
Yeah, stay in touch with us and we'll catch you soon.